लो डेंसिटी, बी रिपल्शन बिटवीन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, रिपल्शन बिटवीन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, एंड सी इट्स लो एटॉमिक नंबर, इट्स लो एटॉमिक नंबर, नेक्स्ट अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, अट्रैक्शन बिटवीन नॉन बॉन्डिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, दीज आर दी गिवन ऑप्शन. ओके राइट, व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन हियर? द बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी ऑफ एफ टू, दिस इज लाइक दिस, is very low is due to earth. This is option B is correct one. Repulsions between non-bonding electrons due to small size, due to small size and high electron negativity, that means due to small size here there is electrons are accommodated in small space, so there is a repulsion takes place between these are non-bonding electrons. Okay, due to this is having low bond dissociation energy. Okay, once again here the bond dissociation energy of F2 is very low. Chlorine ki bond dissociation enthalpy takkuga untundi enduku, so repulsion between non bonding electrons, so this is bonding electron, these are bonding electrons, these one lone pair, two, three lone pairs are lone pairs of electrons on the chlorine. This is having also three lone pair of electrons. So here, due to small size of chlorine atom in a chlorine molecule, there is a repulsion between non-bonding electrons. In non-bonding means there is no participating in chemical bond formation. And the bond formation no participate cheyakunda unde vaatini non-bonding electrons ani cheptam. Okay, due to small size of chlorine, if chlorine atoms ki small size undatam valla, okay, ikkada repulsion takes place between these non bonding electrons. Due to this reason chlorine has a low bond dissociation energy. Okay, not normal. So next one, big number 18. Halogen with highest bond energy. Halogen with highest bond energy. Halogen with highest bond energy. Chlorine, C, bromine, D, iodine. Right. This is the question. What is the question here? Halogen with highest bond energy. Highest bond energy would be halogen energy. Chlorine, F2, Cl2, Br2, I2. So in general here, generally, as the size of halogen atom increases, bond length also increases. bond length also increases. So here size of atom increases, bond length also increases. So then bond strength decreases. Why? Because the bond strength is inversely proportional to bond length. Bond strength nothing but bond energy. So here this bond energy is inversely proportional to bond length. That means as the bond length increases, bond strength decreases. So for example here, the size of the atom increases from fluorine to iodine. Okay, size of the atom increases. Then bond length increases from fluorine to iodine. That means this is fluorine molecule. Okay, this is fluorine molecule. There are three lone pair of electrons on the halogen atom in a molecule. So next bromine. Next last one is iodine. So here, due to increase in the size of halogen atom, bond length increases from fluorine to iodine. Kachandi, fluorine to iodine ki size of the halogen atom increase aitundi. So that's why here bond length increases from fluorine to bromine, bromine to iodine. Totally from fluorine to iodine bond length increases. So here this bond energy is inversely proportional to bond length. That means as the bond length increases, bond energy decreases. Bond length increase ayinappudu bond energy amount decrease avutundi. So from this analogy, so deen prakaram mana observe chesthe fluorine ke undi ikkada minimum bond length, fluorine ke undamma minimum bond length. Bond length takkuva undi kabatti it should have more bond energy. Bond length takkuva undatam valla bond energy ekkuva undali. But in case of iodine here maximum bond length, this is maximum bond length. So it has a minimum bond energy, inversely proportional kada. Bond length ekkuva unnappudu sari bond length takkuva, fluorine in case of fluorine bond length is minimum, bond length takkuva undi kaadu bond strength ela undali ekkuva undali. But ikkada em avutundi in case of iodine bond length is maximum, so then bond length, bond energy minimum ante takkuva undali. But ikkada em avutundante actually order of bond energy of the halogen is fluorine, bromine, chlorine and iodine. This is actual order of the bond energy. That means here among the halogens chlorine has a highest bond energy. Among the halogens chlorine has the highest bond energy. Okay, but ikkada chudandi manu etla observe chese, what is the statement? I says that here size of the atom increases, bond length increases. Okay, size of the atom increase ayinappudu bond length increase avutundi kabatti bond strength decrease avutundi ani cheppam. So ee statement prakaram manu ila rastam ikkada fluorine ki least bond length, idi highest inka highest. Fluorine to iodine ki bond length increase ayindi kabatti bond strength tagipovali ante fluorine has a maximum bond energy, fluorine ki ekkuva undali kaani fluorine ki takkuva undamma least bond energy. Why? Because here inter electronic repulsion between the non bonding electrons, that's right reason. Inter electronic repulsion between non bonding electrons, ee fluorine ki బాండ్ లెంగ్త్ తక్కువగా ఉండటం వల్ల బాండ్ ఎనర్జీ ఎక్కువగా ఉండాలి కానీ క్లోరిన్ బ్రోమిన్ కంటే కూడా తక్కువగా ఉంది డ్యూ టు దిస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద రీజన్ హియర్ డ్యూ టు ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ బిట్వీన్ ది నాన్ బాండింగ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ చూద్దాం డ్యూ టు ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ between non-bonding electrons. These are non-bonding electrons. It will inter-electronic repulsion in the chlorine subcoon. So what is the question? Halogen with the highest bond energy. So chlorine. Chlorine has the highest bond energy. Understand? Direct finally answer. Bond strength order in the halogen is the bond strength. దానికి రీజన్ జనరల్ గా ఏంటంటే బాండ్ లెంత్ ప్రకారం అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తే క్లోరిన్ కి లీస్ట్ బాండ్ లెంత్ ఉండటం వల్ల హైయెస్ట్ బాండ్ ఎనర్జీ ఉండాలి కానీ లీస్ట్ బాండ్ ఎనర్జీ ఉంది లో బాండ్ ఎనర్జీ ఉంది వై బికాస్ డ్యూ టు ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ క్లోరిన్ లో ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ ఉండటం వల్ల దీని బాండ్ ఎనర్జీ లోయెస్ట్ బట్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ క్లోరిన్ రిమైనింగ్ దీని తర్వాత బాండ్ లెంత్ మినిమం గా ఉండేది ఇదే చూడండి క్లోరిన్ బ్రోమిన్ అయోడిన్ ఈ మూడు అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తే ఈ మూడింటిలో బాండ్ లెంత్ తక్కువగా ఉండేది ఏంటి క్లోరిన్ కార్డ్ బాండ్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఎక్కువగా ఉంది ఇది రీజన్ సో నీట్ గా నోట్ చేసుకోండి ఇది డైరెక్ట్ ఈ సీక్వెన్స్ చేసుకుంటే సరిపోద్ది ఇదంతా జస్ట్ ఓన్లీ ఏంటంటే మీకు కాన్సెప్ట్ అర్థం కావడం కోసం ఇదంతా చెప్పాల్సి వచ్చింది డైరెక్ట్ సీక్వెన్స్ ఇదేనా ఓకే Okay, next. So in halogen, chlorine has the highest bond energy. Next question, question number 19. This is a repeated question. High reactivity of chlorine than other halogens according to Coulson is unknown. Okay, as per Coulson, high reactivity of chlorine than other halogens. Coulson prakaram remaining halogens kante chlorine ki and F2 ki enduku reactivity higher ga untundi. Option 3 is correct one. That means greater repulsion between non-bonding electrons. Cheppam kada repulsion. Okay, that means greater repulsion between non-bonding electrons. That's why it has a lowest bond dissociation enthalpy. So it is a higher reactivity. It has a higher reactivity. So that's why chlorine is also called as super halogen. F2 is super halogen pura antamma due to its high reactivity. Chlorine ki F2 ki reactivity ekkuga untundi. So reactivity ekkuga undatam valla deeni super halogen antam. రియాక్టివిటీ ఎందుకు ఎక్కువగా ఉంటుందంటే డ్యూ టు లో బాండ్ డిసోసియేషన్ ఎంథాల్పీ బాండ్ డిసోసియేషన్ ఎంథాల్పీ లోయెస్ట్ తక్కువగా ఉంటుంది అంటే ఆ బాండ్ ఈజీగా బ్రేకప్ అయిపోతుంది హాట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎ హై రియాక్టివిటీ మరి ఆ బాండ్ ఎందుకు ఈజీగా బ్రేకప్ అవుతుంది అంటే అక్కడ డ్యూ టు ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్ బిట్వీన్ నాన్ బాండింగ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈ ఫ్లోరిన్ పైన ఉండేటటువంటి నాన్ బాండింగ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ మధ్య ఈ స్ట్రాంగర్ రిపల్షన్స్ ఉండడం వల్ల ఆ బాండ్ ఈజీగా డివైడ్ అయిపోతుంది కాబట్టి ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీలీ ఇట్ ఈస్ రెడీ ఫర్ రియాక్షన్ రియాక్షన్ లో పార్టిసిపేట్ చేయడానికి రెడీగా ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎ హై రియాక్టివిటీ సో ఎఫ్ టు ఈజ్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ సూపర్ హాలోజన్ రైట్ సో నెక్స్ట్ బిట్ నెంబర్ 20 the chemical reactivity of halogen is in the order option A. Next option B. Next option C. Next one D. So here the order of chemical reactivity this is like this so the chemical reactivity of halogen so that means here chemical reactivity fluorine already you know that here fluorine has the highest reactivity and then chlorine and then bromine and then iodine but reactivity that means reactivity of halogen decreases from fluorine to iodine fluorine nundi iodine ki reactivity of halogen ani decrease avutundi so this is correct sequence okay fluorine has the highest reactivity due to low bond dissociation enthalpy that means here there is a ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్స్ బిట్వీన్ నాన్ బాండింగ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఫ్లోరిన్ లో ఇంటర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ రిపల్షన్స్ ఉండటం వల్ల దిస్ హ్యాస్ లో బాండ్ డిసోసియేషన్ ఎంథాల్పీ సో ఎఫ్ టు హ్యాస్ ద హైయెస్ట్ రియాక్టివిటీ సో దిస్ ఈస్ కరెక్ట్ సీక్వెన్స్ ఓకే నోట్ చేసుకోవాలి స్పీడ్ గా Okay, next. Bit number 21. The stability of hydrogen halide is in the order So here, option A, HF, HI, HBr, HCl. Next option B, HI, HBr, HCl, HF. breaks the sea. HF, HCl, HBr, H8. Next one, HCl, HBr, HI, HF. These are given options. So among these options, the stability of hydrogen halide, okay, which one is correct one? Stability of hydrogen halide. That means already I say here, as the size of halogen atom increases, bond length also increases. Then bond strength decreases. So then stability also decreases. Okay, when size of halogen atom increases ayinappudu bond length em avutundi, increase avutundi. But bond length increase endante bond strength decreases. Why? Because here bond strength is inversely proportional to bond length. So when bond strength decreases, stability also decreases. Why? Because here bond strength is directly proportional to stability. That means stability is directly proportional to bond strength. Okay. Come HF to HI. HF, HCl, HBr, HI. From HF to HI in hydrogen halide, fluorine to iodine, size of the halogen atom increases. So from HF to HI, bond length increases kavadam valla HF to HI bond strength em avutundi, decrease ayipothi. Bond strength decrease kavadam valla stability kuda decrease avutundi. So in this here, HF is a most stable. This is least stable. Also increases, but then bond strength decreases, so that's why here stability also decreases. So HF is a most stable, so that means the bond present in between hydrogen and fluorine in HF, it is more strong. So it does not give easily H plus ion, so it is a weak acid. And HI, weak bond is present here. Okay, as the size increases, fluorine to iodine here, the extent of overlapping also decreases. And akada there is a loosely holding. Okay, ee bond lo hydrogen iodide loosely ga holding avutundi, that is weak bond. So it is easily deviated, so it is a weak stable and it is more strong acidic nature. Next, bit number 22. This is also repeated one. That means same concept here. Bond dissociation enthalpy of HF, HC or HBr follow the order. Bond dissociation. Bond dissociation energy is of HF, HCl, HBr follow the order. Follow the order. So option A, HCl, HBr, HF. Next option B, HF, HBr, HCl. Next C, HF, HCl and HBr. HBr. Next D, HBr, HCl, HF. Right. So in this bond dissociation energy of HF, HCl, HBr. So bond dissociation energy come to the solution again. Size of halogen atom increases, bond length increases, then bond strength decreases. So size of the halogen atom, దేంట్లో తక్కువగా ఉంటే దానికి బాండ్ లెంత్ తక్కువగా ఉంటుంది, సో బాండ్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఎక్కువ. సో దట్ ఈస్ సి. సో ఫ్లోరిన్ హ్యాస్ ఎ స్మాల్ సైజ్, సో ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎ మినిమం బాండ్ లెంత్, మోర్ స్ట్రాంగ్, ఆర్ బాండ్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఈజ్ హై. సో దిస్ HF హ్యాస్ ఎ హైయెస్ట్ బాండ్ డిసోసియేషన్ ఎనర్జీ కంపేర్డ్ టు దట్ ఆఫ్ HCl, HBr అండ్ HI ఆల్సో. Why? Because in HF, size of the fluorine atom is lower, so bond length is lower, then bond strength is higher. Okay. Another reason, important ante, due to presence of hydrogen bonding. If hydrogen bonds for untayamma, aa reason kuda cheppochu. Okay. Due to presence of hydrogen, intermolecular hydrogen bonding in HF molecule, it has a more bond dissociation energy. That's why also. Okay, next. Question number 23. The reaction of which halogen which halogen with water is endothermic. Okay, options are fluorine, bromine and iodine. Among these halogen, which halogen with water is endothermic? In generally, reaction of halogens with water decreases from fluorine to iodine. Fluorine nundi iodine ki water to react capacity decreases. So iodine does not dissolve in water. Okay, so option D is correct one. Why? Because in the case of iodine here, iodine is a solid. So idi water lo dissolve kavalante In iodine, there is a strong force of attraction are required. Strong force of attraction are present. So for breaking this bond, some amount of energy is required. So this iodine, some amount of energy required, and then it is going to dissolve in water. So that means here, then delta H is positive. That is endothermic. And the iodine lo ne bond break up kavadaniki some amount of energy absorb chestundani cheppam kada. So absorption of energy takes place in this reaction. So this is the endothermic. Delta H is positive. So then delta H is positive, delta G also positive. That is change in Gibbs energy. It is a non-spontaneous reaction. So due to these reasons, it is an endothermic reaction. So option D is correct one. Once again here, I2 is a solid. So there is a strong force of attraction present in the iodine. But these attractions are weakened. ఈ అట్రాక్షన్స్ వీక్ కావడానికి లేదంటే ఆ బాండ్ బ్రేకప్ కావడానికి ఈ సమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎనర్జీని అబ్జార్బ్ చేస్తుంది. దట్ మీన్స్ దెర్ ఈస్ ఏ అబ్జార్ప్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎనర్జీ టేక్ ప్లేస్. ఎనర్జీ లిబరేషన్ అయితే ఎక్సోథర్మిక్, ఎనర్జీ అబ్జార్బ్ అయినప్పుడు ఎండోథర్మిక్. ఇక్కడ ఎనర్జీ అబ్జార్బ్ అయితే ఉంది కాబట్టి దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎండోథర్మిక్. రైట్, next. Question number 24. Which of the following is the weakest acid? Which of the following is the weakest acid? So options, four options are given. That is HF, next one HCl, next one HBr and HI. So here four options are given. In among the HF, HCl, HBr, HI, which is the weakest acid? Atomic strength of hydrogen halide HF, HCl, HBr, HI. So here this is a weak acid, weakest acid. Generally the substance which gives H plus ions easily, that is more acidic. So here, due to presence of hydrogen bonding, HF lo hydrogen bonding untundi, so it is not give easily H plus ion. It is easy H plus ions available. Inkoti entante, it contains minimum bond length. Bond length takkuva untundi. So here, bond strength is higher. Bond strength, smaller the bond length will be stronger the bond strength, and I mean greater the bond strength. Bond length takkuga undadam valla bond strength ekkuga untundi, because it does not give H plus ions easily. So it is a weakest acid. Okay, why? Because minimum bond length and maximum bond strength. Minimum bond length, maximum bond strength. Okay, at the same time it contains hydrogen bonding. So here it does not give H plus ion easily. So that's why it is a weakest acid. But in case of HI, maximum bond length, minimum bond strength, so it is ready to give H plus ion. So it is a strong acid. It is a weakest acid. Okay, note this problem. So next, question number 25. Question number 25. Which one of the following pairs of which one of the following pairs of reactants does not form oxygen when they react with each other. Right. Option A, F2, NaOH solution in which is in hot and concentration. This is hot and concentration. Next one, F2 and H2O. Okay, next Cl2 and NaOH solution, cold and dilute. Next option D, bleaching powder CaO, Cl2 and HbSO4. It is a dilute and small amount. These are given options. So what is the question here? Which one of the following phase of reactant does not form oxygen when they react with each other? See, consider ఒక pair ఇచ్చారు. దీంట్లో ఇది react అయినప్పుడు ఏ pair వీటు ఆక్సిజన్ ఇవ్వదు. సో అది ఇవ్వదు అంటే four reactants ను observe చేయాలి. First reaction is here. First one, 2F2+4NaOH, which is in hot and concentrated. It gives 4NaF, sodium fluoride, and water molecules and oxygen. So it gives oxygen. So it is not correct. Okay. In question here, pair of reactants does not form oxygen. So it forms oxygen. This is not wrong. Sorry, this is the wrong answer. Next one, second option, F2+H2O. That means chlorine and water combines to each other. It forms hydrogen fluoride and oxygen. It is also giving oxygen. So it is not correct answer. Third one, Cl2+NaOH. It is cold and dilute. This is cold and dilute. So here, this chlorine and the sodium hydroxide, these both are reacting with each other. It forms NaCl, sodium chloride and sodium hypochlorite and water. So this is not giving oxygen. So this is a correct answer. Next, come to the calcium oxychloride. That means bleaching powder CaO, Cl2+H2SO4. This is in small quantity, dilute and small amount of sulfuric acid. Here, calcium sulfate and calcium chloride, calcium sulfate, calcium chloride, and 2 moles of hypochlorous acid. This is HOCl. HOCl is which is unstable. Which is unstable. So this HOCl on decomposition, it gives HCl and nascent oxygen. So it is also giving oxygen. So among these four phases, chlorine and NaOH does not giving oxygen. So this is correct option. So reaction with alkali chusam chudandi. Two chlorine chlorine. Ivu rendu kuda reaction with alkali directly chesam. Chlorine when combined with hot and concentrated sulfur, sodium hydroxide, it forms sodium chloride, water and oxygen. Chlorine combines with water, it forms hydrogen chloride and oxygen. Chlorine combines with cold and dilute NaOH, forms sodium chloride, sodium hypochlorite and water. As a hot and concentrated, sodium chloride, sodium chlorate. Sorry, dilute, cold and dilute NaOH, so halide, hypohalite. And hot and concentrated NaOH, so halide, halate. Okay, you note just one. Among these four phases, chlorine and sodium hydroxide combines to each other. It does not give oxygen. So this is suitable answer for this question. Equations need to be four equations ready. Decomposition of HOCl also ready. This is unstable, so it gives on decomposition. It gives HCl and nascent oxygen. So next one. Question number 26. So 26 is bleaching action of chlorine is due to, that is oxidation. Direct question. So option one is correct one. Bleaching action of chlorine is due to oxidation. Next 27, it is also repeated one. The least powerful oxidant in presence of water, that is iodine. It is also, so 27. The least powerful oxidant in presence of H2O. in presence of H2O is the least powerful oxidant. So option A. Four options are given here. Chlorine, bromine, and iodine. So this is correct one. Why? Because generally reactivity of halogen with water decreases from chlorine to iodine. Chlorine and iodine ki reactivity is, water to reaction decrease aipoyadu. Generally oxidant, what is the oxidant here? Oxidant means oxidizing agent. So in general, oxidizing agent undergoes reduction. Reduction means, what is the reduction here? Gain of electrons takes place. So electrons gain kavalante small size undali. Ikkada em unnadu powerful oxidant, least powerful. So least powerful means that is not undergo reduction easily. అదంత ఈజీ రిడక్షన్ లో పార్టిసిపేట్ చేయకూడదు, అంటే ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈజీగా గెయిన్ చేయకూడదు. ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ గెయిన్ చేయలేదు అంటే దట్ మస్ట్ బి కంటెంట్ హియర్ లార్జ్ అటామిక్ సైజ్ అమాంగ్ ది ఫ్లోరిన్ హాలోజన్. అమాంగ్ ది హాలోజన్ అయోడిన్ హ్యాస్ ఏ లార్జెస్ట్ అటామిక్ సైజ్. సో దట్స్ వై ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఏ లీస్ట్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ లీస్ట్ పవర్ఫుల్ ఆక్సిడెంట్. లార్జెస్ట్ అటామిక్ సైజ్ ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ గెయిన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఈజీలీ. Okay, they undergo reduction. That means it is not undergo reduction easily. It's one, it is very simple. Iodine has a large atomic size. Iodine ki atomic size ekkuva untundi kaabatti id electrons and easy ga gain cheyaledu kaabatti it is the least powerful oxidizing agent. Okay, strong oxidizing agent ante electrons easy ga lageyali, alanti vaatini strong. ఇది అంత ఈజీగా అట్రాక్ట్ చేయలేదు కాబట్టి లీస్ట్ పవర్ఫుల్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ ఏజెంట్. ఇప్పుడు స్ట్రాంగెస్ట్ అన్నాం, ఇప్పుడు స్ట్రాంగెస్ట్ ఆక్సిడేషన్ ఏజెంట్ అంటే క్లోరిన్. డ్యూ టు ఇట్ స్మాల్ సైజ్ ఉండటం వల్ల ఇట్ ఈస్ రెడీ టు గెయినింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. ఇది ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ గెయిన్ చేయడానికి రెడీగా ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి ఇట్ ఈస్ స్ట్రాంగ్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ వీక్ రైట్. సో నోట్ చేసుకోవాలి త్వరగా. Next, bit number 28. Which is the strongest oxidizing agent? Same sequence. It's like a same option tonight. Which is the strongest oxidizing agent? Chlorine and answer. Option 1. Next, 29. Page number 178. 29 bit number. Chlorine is a stronger oxidizing agent than chlorine in aqueous solution. This is attributed to many factors except anadma. క్లోరిన్ స్ట్రాంగెస్ట్ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్ అన్నాం కదా, దాని హీట్ ఆఫ్ డిసోసియేషన్ అండ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఎఫినిటీ, అయనైజేషన్ పొటెన్షియల్, హీట్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రేషన్. సో 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 4 దీస్ ఆర్ కన్సిడర్డ్, బట్ 3 ఇస్ దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ కన్సిడర్డ్ ఫర్ దిస్ రీజన్. దట్ మీన్స్ అయనైజేషన్ పొటెన్షియల్, 3 ఈజ్ కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్. అక్కడ ఆ క్వశ్చన్ కి సూటబుల్ ఆన్సర్ 3. చూడండి, 28 కి 1, 29 కి 3. స్ట్రాంగెస్ట్ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్ అన్నాడు, దానికి ఆన్సర్ క్లోరిన్. వై? బికాజ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఏ స్మాల్ సైజ్. ఓకే, డ్యూ టు ఇట్ స్మాల్ సైజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రెడీ టు యాక్సెప్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ రెడీ యాక్సెప్ట్ చేయడానికి రెడీగా ఉంటుంది. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఈజీ అండర్గోస్ రిడక్షన్. సో క్లోరిన్ ఈజ్ ఏ స్ట్రాంగెస్ట్ ఆక్సిడైజింగ్ ఏజెంట్. అయోడిన్ ఈజ్ ఏ weak oxidizing agent, that means least powerful oxidizing agent. Why? Because it has a large size, it has a small size. Okay, it is not ready to acceptance of electrons, it is ready to acceptance of electrons. Okay, that is the difference between chlorine and iodine. Okay, next question number 30. oxidizing agent that undergoes reduction, reducing agent undergoes oxidation. Oxidation means loss of electron, reduction means gain of electron. So question number 30. Which of the following halogens? Which of the following halogen? Following halogen form only one oxo acid. Form only one oxy acid. Option A, chlorine. B, chlorine. C, bromine. D, iodine. So that is fluorine is correct one. Why? Because it's a small size and high electronegativity. Okay, fluorine. It is only one oxide, that means HOF. HOF. So remaining this tomorrow class lo complete cheddam avi. So neat ga once again I am telling you, ee roju aa roju complete ga practice cheyali, theory running also follow ayi tarvata bits kuda neat ga practice chesi pettandi, homework problems kuda practice cheyali. Okay.